Aloha, big kids. Miss Patton here. Today I have a new story for us to read, and the story actually comes from a chapter book. And so this is our book. It's called Frog and Toad Together, and it's written by Arnold LaBelle. So I can find my title because it's my big words. And then Arnold LaBelle is my author and illustrator down here. Just like in your journal, how you are the author and illustrator. So we're looking at our front cover. Then we have our back cover, our spine, and inside we have our title page. And this is one of my favorite books, and it's a little bit old, and so you can see some of these pages are a little bit damaged. But I'm going to try my best to still take care of it. I love this book. So this here is my title page. It's got a little rip on it, but it has my title, my author and my illustrator, and a picture. So this is my title page. And remember, the author writes the words, and the illustrator draws the pictures. So Arnold LaBelle is doing both for this story. All right, our table of contents. Today we're going to read a list. It starts on page 4. So as we're reading today, the kids, I want you to be thinking about our characters or who the story is about. All right, here we go. A list. One morning, Toad sat in bed. "I have many things to do," he said. "I will write them all down on a list so that I can remember them." Toad wrote on a piece of paper, "A list of things to do today." Then he wrote, "Wake up." "I've done that," said Toad, and he crossed that out. Good writers make lists to help them remember things. Then Toad wrote other things on the paper. "A list of things to do today. Wake up, eat breakfast, get dressed, go to Frog's house. Take a walk with Frog, eat lunch, take a nap, play games with Frog, eat supper, go to sleep." "There," said Toad, "now my day is all written down." He got out of bed, had something to eat. Then Toad crossed off, "Eat breakfast." So far we have one character that we have seen, and he is Toad. Here I'm talking about a friend. Remember that friend's name? Frog. If I look back at my front cover here, remember my front cover said Frog and Toad Together. And I see that one looks like Toad with his brown color. And there's Frog with his green color. Toad took his clothes out of the closet and put them on. He got dressed. Then crossed out, "Get dressed." Toad put the list in his pocket. He opened the door and walked out into the morning. Soon Toad was at Frog's front door. He took the list from his pocket and crossed off, "Go to Frog's house." Toad knocked on the door. "Hello," said Frog. "Look at my list of things to do," said Toad. "Oh," said Frog. "That's very nice," Toad said. "My list tells me that we will go for a walk." "All right," said Frog. "I'm ready." So now I see two characters. What are their names? Toad and Frog. If we're looking at them, what's something that is different? Toad is like a brown green color, browny green kind of color, and Toad is very green. I'm sorry, Frog is very green. I also see Frog is taller than Toad. But you notice it's the same. I see their feet look similar, different colors, but they look like the same. You see their eyes look like they have the same shape. Their mouth looks like they have the same shape. I see that they are both wearing jacket and pants. So those are things the same. Frog and Toad went on a long walk. Then Toad took the list from his pocket and he crossed out, "Take walk with Frog." Just then there was a strong wind. It blew the list out of Toad's hand. The list blew high up into the air. "Help!" cried Toad. "My list is blowing away. What will I do without my list?" "Hurry," said Frog. "We will run and catch it." "No," shouted Toad. "I cannot do that." "Why not?" asked Frog. "Because," wailed Toad, "running after my list is not one of the things that I wrote on my list of things to do." Frog ran after the list. He ran over the hills and swamps, but the list blew on and on. At last, Frog came back to Toad. "I'm sorry," gasped Frog, "but I could not catch your list."
"Blah,"
said Toad. "I cannot remember any of the things that were on my list of things to do. I will just have to sit here and do nothing," said Toad. Toad sat and did nothing. Frog sat with him. "What would be another way you could solve this problem, big kids? If you lost your list, what could you do?" "Try your best to remember and make a new one with the things you do remember." After a long time, Frog said, "Toad, it is getting dark. We should be going to sleep now." "Go to sleep," shouted Toad. "That was the last thing on my list." Toad wrote that on the ground with a stick. "Go to sleep." Then crossed it out. "There," said Toad. "Now my day is all crossed out." "I am glad," said Frog. Then Frog and Toad went right to sleep. So I really like this story because Frog and Toad are such great friends and how they try to help each other out. So today is Free Draw Friday. You can draw anything you would like in your journal. If you would like to tell me about the two characters, Toad and Frog, I would love to see them in your journal. Or maybe a time you went for a walk or you wrote a list and what happened to you. I hope you have a great day and I can't wait to see that great work in your journal. Aloha!